Oh, have his way tonight. He's right in our lives. And obedience is better than sacrifice. It certainly is. We know all it takes is just being obedient. Boy, thank you. They were singing that song. Boy, you're talking about a day. Day after a while, when the saints and that of God Murray heads to their final resting place. Amen. So there is. There remains the rest for the people that of God. There certainly are. Well, I'm glad I'm in that number tonight. Thank you that I ever done. Not the money, not the wealth, not the cars or the houses that I have, but it's what God placed in my heart.
Amen.
That Easter Sunday morning pass, what's going to get me home?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Certainly is. Hope everybody under the sound of my voice tonight's ready and at to go. And if you're not ready tonight, well, you can get ready. Amen. You've still got time tonight. You certainly have. So it's a good place for me to be tonight. It certainly is. Good to see everybody. Hope the Lord just blesses you real good for coming out this way.
Bless you, Lord.
Amen. Here this evening. So I'm ready to go. I certainly am.
Bless you, Lord.
Got something on your heart? Just mind the Lord tonight.
Bless you, Jesus.
God will bless you for it. He certainly will.
Bless you, Lord.
You might be saying, Amazing Grace, with none of these instruments in this time. It's the same as what God gave us tonight.
Amen. Bless you, Lord.
Bless you.
Bless you, Lord. And it might not mean nothing to nobody else, but
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I was lost, but now
Bless him, Lord.
Bless him, Lord.
Bless him, Lord.
Bless him, Lord.
Yeah.
Bless him, Lord.
Tell it, James.
Bless him.
Bless him.
Bless him,
Lord.
Bless him, Lord.
Bless him, Lord. Bless him, Lord. Bless him, Lord.
Song the Lord, but I want to ask the church to sing "Glory, Glory, Glory." Somebody touch me. But before we sing this, I want everybody. I want you to look. That's who's lost here tonight. When we sing this song, I hope there ain't nobody in the bathroom. I hope everybody's here listening to this song, because there's a hell to come if you ain't ready to go. I tell you, I could walk out of this church tonight and get killed. So God's going to get his people back in church. He's going to punish the ones that show that what he desires for God.
Bless it, Lord.
And I'm telling you, we got to be right. If I'm in the way, I need to be on this altar. I went last Sunday down on this altar to make sure it was quilled up with me. And left him something.
Bless it, Lord.
Have I picked it back up? I haven't. But I'm holding it tight. The Lord's got it.
Yeah.
But the devil's always like this. Come on, Moose, you okay? Let's pick it back up. That's what we do. That's what Christians do. That's what I do. But if you can't raise your hand and auto stand, you better be thinking, because there's a hell to come, and I'm telling you. There ain't no way out of it once you're gone. There ain't no way out of it. It's been preached behind this pulpit for the last 14 years I've been back in church, how hell is and how sweet heaven is. And maybe what I'm telling you, if I was lost and my heart was beating out of my chest, I asked somebody to come back and pray with me. We'd come back and pray with me. If we can't, there's something wrong. We've been having too much good services around here to not see somebody move to them.
They're just holding on.
By hanging on. The man preached the word. He preached, and these other preachers around here preached the word. That hell's where and heaven's where too. There's two places. I'd rather take my chance going to heaven is anything else. I'd rather take that chance. I really do, but I'm saying glory, glory, glory. And you look at the hands. You look at the days they got saved. Today could be your day that you got saved. You can have your spark.
Somebody touch me, glory, glory, glory. Somebody touch me, glory, glory, glory. Somebody touch me, I know it was the hand of the Lord. It was on a Monday, somebody touch me.
thank God for being here tonight. Thank God I'm saved. And I've thought about it ever since that preached last night. Good. Talking about how old you was when you got saved, how old Travis was, everybody. When I was about 13 or 14, I lived right next to the church.
Bless him.
I went to the altar, but he went to be saved. He was just working on the basketball team for the church.
Bless him.
Had a Sanskrit teacher for a coach, and every time we win, he'd take us out for a nice beer.
Yeah.
We'd party and go on. I mean, he got out in the world big. Got in alcohol and the pot and everything else. So if you're here and God's deal with you, don't wait that long, but it's hard in my hurry. Come back. When you get in the world, I was 22-year-old. They didn't believe in God, didn't believe in nothing. There was two preachers I worked with.
Yeah.
I walked by the little conference room on lunch break, and they'd be in there studying the Bible. Well, I caught myself stopped by the door and listened to them a little bit every once in a while. Well, one Friday evening, God got a hold of me. If it ain't good for him, well, I'd be in hell today. I ain't have to go no rehab, get off out of hell.
Come on, brother.
God touched me off of it that minute that he saved me.
Bless you.
So don't wait till you get so far out there. You get hard-hearted and you don't believe in nothing before you come to him.
Bless you, God. God bless your heart, brother.
I don't know how he speaks to the oceans and the waves only come so far. How he reaches deep inside. Here's a broken heart. I don't know how he supplies our needs. It's always enough. I don't know how he hears and answers prayer. I'm so glad he's here.
For me, you know, I sit here thinking of my son, he's 13 now, and you know, he's wanting to drive a little bit. And, seems like every time we get in the vehicle, he's nagging up driving. But today on the way home, he wanted to drive, and we started down the road, and he had a little bit of a mess up, and I tried to explain to him, you know, he's a loves video games. I mean, who don't?
Yeah.
But I was trying to explain to him about how dangerous it is in a car, about how you can't push the reset button once you mess up. You know, and I thought about heaven and hell is the same way. I mean, just as soon as I had told him that, he hit me. Yeah. I'm going to tell you, you know, this exact same way. You're going to hell, you're going tonight. There ain't no chance of pushing that reset button. I'll tell you, you know, when I was far off in the world, and I tried to get back to the Lord, I can't tell you how many times I went down to the altar. I'd sit there, and it seemed like every service, I'd go down to that altar, and I'd be like, Lord, please forgive me. Please forgive me. And here we go, it'd be another service, and I'd have to do it. I'm going to tell you, it don't matter how many times you go. As long as you know you've got it, I'm going to tell you, the devil's going to beat you down. You can miss one service or two services, and then when you get back in, the guilt starts to beat you. It ain't going to hurt to come down here and just to make things right with the Lord. I mean, I wouldn't want to wait to get home to try to get it right. I want to get it right as soon as I felt it. You know, I ain't going to lie. I've been down on the altar many times, and there was many times that I picked it up and took it with me. There's been many times I got down there and I left it. God ain't no shameful person. He just wants things right with us. And I'm going to tell you, if I have to go down every service, I don't care. I'm going to go down every service. If I come in here and I start to doubt it, I'm going to be right there and I'm going to ask him again. It don't matter how many times you go, as long as you know you've got it. Just as I said, there's no reset button. It's a no for sure kind of thing tonight. You know, and I want to make sure that I do the right thing because I want my kids to know. You know, that I'm not going to sit here and pat you on the back and tell you, brother, you're going if you ain't going. You know, I want you to know it's between you and God. It's not been said this morning. It was said last night, you know. I can't take you. I've told you, Ashley, many times, if I could, I'd give you mine. I'd give you mine.
Amen.
I can't tell you how many times I get down there and I pray. Lord, I just want to be there. I don't care when it happens. I just want to be there. I want to be there rejoicing with her because it's that good. It's that serious tonight. And it's the same with your child. You know, Travis, your family's complete. I'm excited when my family's complete, but I'm still going to pray for yours.
Amen.
I'm not going to stop just because mine's complete.
Amen.
We all need to get down here and pray for each other.
Amen.
I'm going to tell you, Lord's blessed me. He has blessed me more than I can sit here and say. I'm going to tell you, me and Jeremy was just talking about it. You know, I'm from Good Hope. Well, that's my home. That's where my Bethel is. When I return to the Lord, but when I came here, I've never seen a church like this. I've never felt a service like this one here. As much as I love that church, I don't want to go back. I want to stay right here with you. I mean, I want to stay, and it's not anything anybody's done, but it's the fact that it's the Lord. I want the Lord, and I want more of Him every time I come here. No matter if it's an hour, 2 hours, or 3 hours, I want Him. And that's the way we all need to be. If there's a lost one here, someone that's backslid, I want to pray for you tonight. I want you to know that. I'm going to pray for you. If you want to come down here, I'll get right here with you and pray with you. I love you that much tonight. I'm so thankful for every one of y'all that's here. Y'all made this service possible. Not anything you've done, but the fact that you came here to worship Him. I'm so thankful for His love. Thankful.
I got a song, Marty. I got to sing for him. He's laid on my heart, and it's for somebody, and I know it's real. There was a king who got a letter from a mighty army.
What do we need to do?
God's in the building.
ever come, God, to where you are, Lord, before it's everlasting too late. Lord, we ask you tonight, I pray, God, just give them more of our liberty. God, just give them the courage, God, Lord, to come, Lord, to where you are. Lord, if they might receive, God, Lord, eternal life, Lord, this evening, Lord, I pray. Lord, I'll get you now on something, Lord, as we know how. Lord God, we know, Lord, you hear our cry, Lord, so many times. Lord, we pray tonight, God. Lord, this would be the night, Lord, that we move, God, and come to where you are. Thank you, Lord, tonight, God, for allowing me, Lord, to just be here, God, to be in the midst. God, of your spirit, God, and your power, Lord, and your time, Lord, I thank you, Lord, tonight, God, for it. Lord, and loving me, Lord, like you do. Lord, and taking care of us, Lord, through this swamp wet life, Lord, I thank you. Lord, the sinner, Lord, the name of God out of our hearts, Lord, and that. Lord, we just want to give you, Lord, the praise, Lord, this evening, Lord. God, all the honor, Lord, that, Lord, for you, Lord, this evening. Lord, whatever, Lord, to accomplish, Lord, the remainder, Lord, of this time. God, we know, Lord, only come, God, and then through and by you tonight. God, through your spirit, God, and your power, Lord. Lord, it comes, God, from on high, Lord, this evening. God, help us, Lord, I pray tonight. Lord, we wouldn't stand in nobody's way, Lord. God, you would have us, Lord, to do, Lord, your will tonight. Lord, we pray, Lord, asking you, Lord, to help, Lord, our sister, Lord, that's come. God, we pray tonight, Lord, you would hear her. Lord, our humble cry tonight, Lord, we pray.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
try my best to do the Lord, man.
Somebody else needs to come to see me.
Even the other stuff, I mean, I'm just,